Justin, it's Michael, Red Chair Diaries. Thank you very much. You're always so very generous with your comments. And, you know, those of us on the other end, we do appreciate it. Staying alive. I've got a lot to say about staying alive. And you've asked for it, so you're going to get it. I am not one of the people that hates that movie. I saw, remember, being the older guy here, I saw that movie probably the weekend it opened. I think you said it opened July 83, and Ted and I moved into our first apartment together in July 83, downtown Vancouver, and I know that we went to see that movie at some point because we saw it that summer, so probably early on. I have never been a fan of Saturday Night Fever, and I have tried. And I didn't like that guy in that movie that killed himself in the movie. I just didn't like the characters. I didn't think there was a hell of a lot that was redeeming about the John Travolta character either. You know, that movie's based on a magazine article. You can almost tell. But, you know, I'm a huge fan of the Bee Gees, and I didn't even like most of those songs. You know, I still don't think they personified disco. And the disco era was very important to me. Like, I am a diehard disco fan. It's like that is the music for me, because that's the music I danced to when I went out to the clubs. And I came out in 1974, and disco started full bore. I say it was launched with Donna Summer's album Love to Love You Baby. That's how I marked the beginning of it. That there, of course, there was music before that, but that's in my head. And so my being a young man about town was disco music. And I'm still not that crazy about that soundtrack. But I like the Bee Gees a lot. So I like a lot of their stuff going back to the 60s, for God's sakes. Anyway, so about that movie. The actress is Cynthia. She's Cynthia Rhodes, and as you said, she was in Dirty Dancing. The lead character in this, the female lead, is Finola Hughes, and she still acts sometimes in soap operas on television. And she's supposed to be a really nice person. I know that when I was at Regis and Kelly's show on this morning, it wasn't Regis, he wasn't there, but Kelly mentioned Finola Hughes again, you know, the two people who were two of her good friends from All My Children. So I saw Finola Hughes in person. Now this is where the story gets interesting. Ted and I were in New York in May 89, and I can tell you which month because that's only the second time I've been there. And it's the weekend that Gilda Radner died, so check your calendar because I remember seeing it going by on the, I don't know if it's Times Square, you know, there's this readout that travels with news bulletins, and Gilda Radner did of cancer, so that was a horrible thing to see on the weekend. And we went to see, we saw two things in New York. We saw Jerome Robbins Broadway, which is a dancing and music from various musicals that Jerome Robbins, the choreographer and director, was involved in. And Jason Alexander, a.k.a. George Costanza, was the star of that and won a Tony for it that year. So we went to that one, and we also went to see the stage version of Shirley Valentine with Pauline Collins from England, and she won the Tony for that. So I don't know which movie we were at, or I mean which play, but we went over to Sardi's for dinner afterwards, and we were sent quite far to the back because that's the, you know, the theater restaurant has all the history and people pour into it. And Finola Hughes was with a party at the table next to us at the very back of the restaurant, and she was talking about the play or the musical. I really don't remember the content. But I remember that I knew who she was. I was saying, Ted, that's Finola Hughes. You know, she was in Stayin' Alive. And she was a dancer by trade, you know, that she was trained. Now, so besides that, but I didn't bother her. I didn't ask for an autograph or anything like that. But Ted always says that these people are listening to what I've got to say because I'm so loud and I'm telling stories that are more interesting than theirs. Anyway, that's, I digress, you know. Bring it back to Michael, right? All the time. A terrible habit. But that movie, I think where a lot of people were against that movie was that it was so fucking over the top, okay? Because it was too much to be a sequel to Staying Alive, just like you said, that if it was John Travolta in something else, like he did Grease, you know, in 78, and it might have been more accepted, but it was the two things, you know, how dare Rocky direct a musical with Tony Manera, or whatever his name was, in the movie. And as a moviegoer and a musical lover, I couldn't buy him in that role, even though it was supposedly a sequel, because people from his background of disco dancing don't become basically ballet dancers, which was what this, a lot of that theatrical was, modern jazz dancing and so on in that movie. But still, if you bought into the rest of it, it was quite entertaining. Like yourself, I really liked that back end of the movie. I mean, the whole stage door nonsense, you know, the sort of thing like All About Eve and all of that sort of stuff, and being a bitch, and, you know, I mean, we've all seen that a lot, you know. But that was quite a number. And my opinion about numbers like that is that when I see them in the movies, you know they can't possibly actually exist on a Broadway stage because it's too much. Like, the stuff that's on stages now was not stuff that was on stages in 1982 or 83, if you follow what I'm saying, you know. And, but it is entertaining. It is entertaining. I think another thing that put people off, besides having Sly Stallone linked with John Travolta for that movie, was some of the publicity photos. It was basically John Travolta in tights or what looked like pantyhose with flare bottoms or something. And, you know, I guess I could enjoy that, but I think a lot of people didn't really like that sort of outfit on him, you know. The, what else? And also he got quite pumped up. So he was under, if you know the backstory, he was under, well, he might have been under him for all I know, under Sylvester Stallone's tutelage for being pumped up like that. And Stallone, you know, is suspected of having taken steroids and all that sort of stuff anyway. But remember, alleged, I don't know. I don't want any lawsuits. So there was that, and I think all of that publicity ended up actually backfiring and just kind of tainting the movie in some way. Anyway, those are some of my theories, but I do remember the movie, and I did enjoy it when I went to see it, so there's no issue about that. And, you know, I really respect you more, not because you said nice things about me, because you're nice to most of us, I think, but because you've got this movie in your archives. I can't even believe it. I was thinking about this movie the other day, and, you know, you're talking about it. Like, 1 week you're talking about Slash. Oh, my favorite slashers are, there's my Slasher collection, you know, there's my Halloween collection, there's my Freddy Krueger collection. And then you're saying, well, Michael, I want to enter part C of your contest, and I'm going to discuss John Travolta in Staying Alive. And it's just, it is funny, you know, like, I just like that variety. I like that. It's called eclecticism, you know. So that's terrific. I like that. I don't like just one kind of thing. I think people, you know, have to open their eyes to different kinds of entertainment. Me too, me included. I mean, I opened my eyes to opera a long time ago because of Ted, and I really like it. So, you know, anything's possible. Okay, anyway, those are some of my stories, and I've gone on longer than your tape because I'm almost at 10 minutes, but I hope it was entertaining, and thanks a lot. You are awesome and amazing.